I welcome you all in this video program of planning. In this program, today we have our guest, Dr. B.K. Pandey. He is associated with the Planning Commission of India. He is here with us to discuss more comprehensively about planning, the objective and needs of planning. About this program, before we start, sir, I want to say only one thing. As we all know, if we are not planning, means we are planning to fail, or we can say that failing to plan is also planning to fail only. If we are not planning also, then also we are planning for some negative results. So why not to plan? And planning is the need of our everywhere. We need to plan something. We need to plan even for small event, for our future also. Because we people, our learners are future goal oriented, they also plan for something. Today we will discuss about planning, about economic planning in India. So I request our expert of the day, this program, to start with the planning in India, about economics planning. Sir, please.
Thank you, Dr. Manish, and I am grateful to National Open School for inviting me to deliberate on this important topic. Today we will take up this very interesting subject of planning in India, and why planning is required for all organization, not only organization, whether they are in private sector or in public sector or even country as a whole, why it is important to plan. First of all, what is a plan? Plan gives us some kind of direction, some kind of, you know, goal, and how this goal is to be achieved, by which kind of resources, what kind of manpower requirement, what is the material requirement. As you can see, planning is an attempt to find direction, to find resources, and to put where our resources should be used. And in which direction the country has to go, what are the critical areas, what are the gaps which needs to be filled up. We started planning process in 1951, and for that we created one institution which is known as Planning Commission of India. The Planning Commission of India, which was set up in 1951 by a government resolution, and this resolution created one central body known as Planning Commission of India, and this is headed by the Prime Minister of the country. In any plan, we assess what is the critical gaps which needs to be filled up, what are the priority areas, and we take assessment of the situation, and then we plan and we see how, what are the main objectives, what are the, you know, areas which require a special effort, and how these resources and this plan have to be implemented, and then we monitor it also. Like when the plan is executed, we have a midterm appraisal which takes into account how this whether we are on the path, whether we are deviating from the path, what are the corrective measures which has to be taken. All these exercises are underway when the plan is under execution. Now, let us look at the broad objective of the planning. In India, if you look at our planning, you know, history or planning process, we find that we have been, or our planning process has been concerned with economic growth, how to increase the rate of growth of the country, how to, you know, be self-reliant in certain critical and strategic areas, how to remove unemployment, how to reduce income inequality, and how to reduce level of poverty in the country. So these has been the objectives of the planning, and these are the common theme in all the plans, that whatever may be the specific goals of a particular plan, these common theme you will find woven in each plan. Now, let us look at the first 5-year plan. The first 5-year plan, which is started in, and which period was 1951 to 1956. In this plan, you will find that our emphasis was on agriculture development, and we targeted that our agriculture development should be given priority. The plan address, you know, this sector, agrarian sector, and lot of irrigation projects came up, and we made investment in dams, and as a result our agriculture growth picked up during this plan. Then we come to the second 5-year plan, where the emphasis was on industrialization, and this was a very important plan. The period was 1956 to 1961, and during this period we planned heavy industrialization of the country, and public sector was given a lot of importance in this plan. And the public sector units like steel, you know, plants were set up during this plan, and this plan was based on the model developed by Prashant Chandra Mahalanobis, who was a statistician, and he gave a lot of emphasis on capital goods sector. So this plan is known for pushing industrialization in the country, to give priority to the public sector units, and this laid a solid foundation of industrialization in the country. Then we came to third 5-year plan, where again the emphasis was on agriculture, because we found that to some extent agriculture was neglected during the second 5-year plan. So again the focus shifted to improving production in agriculture, especially green revolution, you know, the seeds for green revolution were sown during this period of third 5-year plan, and there was an emphasis on increasing productivity in rice, wheat, and this plan also made efforts to provide more employment opportunities to the people in the country, and the target for growth was 5%. The fourth 5-year plan, the period is 1969 to 1974, and here the emphasis was on self-reliance, and the growth rate was targeted to be achieved as 5.7%, and lot of emphasis was put on increasing export in this plan, and also there was reforms and restructuring of government expenditure. That was the agenda of this fourth 5-year plan. In fifth 5-year plan, the emphasis was on employment, poverty alleviation, and how to have social and economic justice. And this plan also put emphasis on expansion of productive employment and fuller utilization of existing skills and equipment. So this plan was aimed at utilizing our resources in efficient manner, and how to use existing skills and equipment for faster economic development. In sixth 5-year plan, the emphasis was on family planning, to improve productivity in the economy, to modernize the technological level of the country, to develop indigenous energy and efficient energy uses, to promote improved quality of life of citizens. So this was also an important event in the planning, because this plan wanted that country should modernize and become technologically self-reliant. In the seventh 5-year plan, which took up the goal of social justice, removal of oppression of the weak, it focused on how to use modern technology, how to use agricultural development, and it also started anti-poverty programs and to increase productivity of small and large scale farmers. So these were some of the critical issues which were dealt during 7th 5-year plan. In 8th 5-year plan, the period was 1992 to 1997, and here again emphasis was on modernization of industries, and during this plan Indian economy was gradually opened to world economy. It started the process of linking Indian economy with the world economy, and major objectives of this plan included containing population growth, poverty reduction, employment generation, strengthening the infrastructure, institutional building, human resource development, involvement of Panchayat Raj, Nagar Palikas, NGOs, and decentralization and people's participation in the execution of planning projects. In 9th 5-year plan, the period involved 1997 to 2002, and the main aim were speedy industrialization, human development, full-scale employment, poverty reduction, self-reliance on domestic resources, and main objective of the plan were to prioritize agriculture sector, because the agriculture growth was coming down, to emphasize on rural development, to generate adequate employment opportunities, and to promote poverty reduction, and to ensure food and nutritional security of the citizens of the country. In 10th 5-year plan, the period 2002 to 2007, the main objective of the 10th 5-year plan were reduction of poverty, providing gainful and high quality employment, and reduction in gender gaps in literacy and wage rate by at least 50% by 2007, and how to increase literacy rate to 75% within the 10th plan period. So these were the major objectives of 10th 5-year plan. 11th plan, which started in 2007 and which ended just last year, in this plan the emphasis was to increase the growth rate, and the objective was to increase the GDP growth rate from 8% to 10%, and then maintain 10% the growth rate in the 12th plan, which is begin very soon during 2012, and agriculture growth rate was targeted to 4% per year, and it was also planned to create 70 million new job opportunities, to reduce infant mortality rate to 28 and maternal mortality rate to 1 per 1,000 live births, to provide clean drinking water for all the people by 2009, and to ensure that there are no slip up in these targets. In infrastructure, the 11th plan tried to ensure electricity connection to all villages and BPL households by 2009, and to provide round the clock power, to ensure all weather road connection to all habitations with population above 1,000, and to connect every village by telephone by November 2007, and to provide broadband connectivity to all villages by 2012. In environment, the goal of the 11th plan was to increase forest cover by 5%, to attain WHO standards of air quality in all major cities by 2011-12, to treat all urban waste water by 2011-12, to clean river waters, and to increase energy efficiency by 20% point by 2016-17. So these were the goals of infrastructure in the 11th 5-year plan. If we look at what has happened and our experience with the 11th plan, we find that we have managed to achieve a growth rate of about 8% during the 11th plan, and which is although short of the target of 9%, but looking at global crisis and drought in certain part of the country, this can be taken as a very good achievement of planning. Second, we have also seen very impressive progress in area of agriculture growth, poverty reduction, education, health, upliftment of SC/STs and minority communities during this plan. So 11th plan can be summed up as a very successful planning experience. Now if we look at 12th plan, which is going to be launched very soon, this is the first year of the 12th 5-year plan, that is 2012-17. And the planning commission has already discussed what should be the approach to the 12th five-year plan. As you know, every plan, when it is launched, it has to be approved by the National Development Council, and the meeting of the National Development Council, which is attended by all the chief ministers and governors and the important ministers of the central cabinet, this is likely to meet sometime very soon, and they will finalize what should be the main priorities and main objective of the 12th five-year plan. The planning commission has already put, you know, some of the critical issues and has sought the comments of the public and the civil society at large. These comments are being taken into account while formulating the plan. And if we look at planning commission approach to the 12th five-year plan, we find that this plan, the basic objective is going to be faster growth rate, more inclusive and sustainable growth. It would aim perhaps 9 to 9.5% growth. The area will be where more effort will be needed will be energy, water, environment, and also there will be emphasis on education and health sector, and agriculture growth may be targeted at 4%. So, in I have tried to cover the planning history of India from 1951 to starting from first five-year plan to 12th beginning of the 12th five-year plan, and we find that we have been able to achieve a lot of success in terms of poverty reduction, in terms of faster growth. India is one of the leading country in the world where the growth has been very high, about 7 to 8% in the last decade, and this has resulted in reduction of poverty. This has led us to be self-reliant in many areas, and what we find that in the 12th five-year plan, we will try to take up those areas. Like we will focus more on inclusive growth, we will try to focus on those areas which are backward or those communities which have not joined the mainstream. So, that is going to be the challenge for the 12th five-year plan, and for that consultation process is on, and very soon you will find that the 12th plan will be launched.
Sir, we got independence in 1947, but we have started our planning process, means planning decisions, in 1951. Why we are late for 3 years?
India became republic in 1950.
Yes, okay.
And after India becoming republic in 1950, we started, although it is not that the planning, there was no idea of planning.
Mm-hmm.
Even prior to independence, there was a Bombay plan.
Okay.
And even in the, you know, the Congress committee meetings, Pandit Nehru, the first Prime Minister, even prior to independence had talked about that planning bill be required to put country on the high growth path, and he was influenced by the Soviet model. So, it took some time to formulate and to come out with, you know, a strategy of planning and to put the institutions which are required to formulate and to implement the planning. So, it took some time.
Okay.
So, it was not that the planning was, yes, there was some delay,
mm-hmm.
but before you launch a plan, you need certain, you know, certain institutions to, which can monitor, and that is why planning commission was created in 1950 by a cabinet resolution, and Prime Minister was made its chairman, and it shows the importance which was given to planning in India.
Okay, and we also have questions from our learners. We have first question from first learner.
Sir, my name is Manish Jain, and I am also a NIOS learner. My question to you is, planning is pervasive?
Yes, it's a very good question, Manish. Planning is pervasive in the sense that, you know, planning, nobody can afford to ignore planning. Because if you ignore planning, then you are, you know, planning for failure, as Dr. Manish said in the beginning itself. So, whether it is a small organization, whether it is a private sector or public sector, today every organization has plans. And because if you plan, then you can visualize, you can anticipate, and you can mobilize resources. Instead of, you know, being unprepared, planning makes you, you know, ready for meeting the challenge. So planning is required, and it is all pervasive in the sense that it is required by all the organizations, and that is why the country, the even national, you know, priorities are to be tackled by right kind of planning. So planning enables you to prioritize. It enables you to find the direction. Where are we going? How we will go? And what are the resources required for, you know, going where we intend to go? So that way, I think yes, planning is. I agree that planning is all pervasive to a great extent. I mean, we cannot afford to afford not to plan.
Sir, my name is Samyak Jain, and I am also an IOS learner. My question is, what is self-reliance?
Self-reliance means the country should be able to meet its requirement through its own internal sources, and this has been one of the, you know, important objective of our plan, that in certain critical areas like food, like energy, and in other areas, we should be able to meet our requirements by domestic production. And to a large extent, you will find that we have been able to meet and we have achieved the goal of self-reliance. Today India is self-reliant in a matter of food safety, food security, and as you know, before independence, India was in a very bad state, and we have been able to meet. So, self-reliance is a very important objective, and we have been able to fulfill, and we have become self-reliant in many critical areas of the economy.
So, sir, at the end, I just conclude with this, ki in present scenario, all visionary people, visionary organization, institution, government organization, they are planning because they are visionary, or they want to become successful if they plan in a very appropriate and very critical way. This is the thing, ki, like we said, ki planning is pervasive. So pervasive nature of planning make it compulsory, mandatory, or it is a normal course of action ki we have to plan everywhere?
Dr. Manish, we cannot undermine the importance of planning, but there has been some change in our, you know, we have moved from mindset, you know, command planning to indicative planning.
Yes, yes.
Like we are giving a lot of importance to private sector. Mm-hmm. Earlier, state or public sector, they were playing a critical role in our economic development. But now, if you find in the from 10th plan or onwards, we are giving a lot of emphasis to private sector, because a lot of dynamism in the economy, mm-hmm, comes from private sector.
Yes.
So how private sector can be galvanized, how they can be made, you know, more dynamic, and the planning commission or the planning process is to provide some kind of incentive to them. So we want that private sector should play a very great role in the planning process. So okay, the role of planning is there, it will be there for the government, and for the public sector will continue to play important role, but we also want that private sector should come out with initiatives, and the focus of the 12th plan will be how to make private sector more dynamic, in the economy. Okay. That is what we intend to.
Okay. Thank you, sir, for being with us, for supporting our learner in knowing what is planning in their life also, and in running our economy in a very perfect way. And I, on behalf of NIOS, I extend my heartfelt thanks to you for sparing your valuable time for us, for giving and enlighten our learners also with your thoughts, and what you are doing at your department is the same all about the planning. So we do have other session also. Now in the another sessions, we will take some case studies related to planning in different areas. So
thank you, Dr. Manish, and I'm thankful to National Open School for inviting me. And I have also learned by participating in this very interesting discussion and the role of planning. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
घर बैठे पाएं राष्ट्रीय मुक्त विद्यालय शिक्षा संस्थान यानी NIOS में एडमिशन, वो भी एकदम आसान तरीके से, जिससे शिक्षार्थियों को होगी समय और धन दोनों की बचत। NIOS से शिक्षा कभी भी कहीं भी। शिक्षार्थियों, क्या आप जानते हैं NIOS में एडमिशन लेने का सरल और सुगम तरीका, जिससे शिक्षार्थियों को ऑनलाइन प्रवेश लेने में सहूलियत मिलती है। NIOS में प्रवेश की प्रक्रिया पूर्णतया ऑनलाइन है। शिक्षार्थी घर बैठे इंटरनेट द्वारा प्रवेश के लिए सबसे पहले NIOS की वेबसाइट www.nios.ac.in पर लॉगिन करें। अपना ईमेल आईडी और पासवर्ड डालकर अपना पंजीकरण करें। पंजीकरण के बाद लॉगिन करने पर ऑनलाइन प्रवेश हेतु आवेदन पत्र खुलेगा। आवेदन पत्र को निर्देशानुसार भरें और प्रिंट आउट लें। इस प्रिंट आउट पर अपनी फोटो संलग्न करें। ऑनलाइन प्रवेश के लिए शुल्क हेतु भुगतान के तरीके हैं, क्रेडिट कार्ड के द्वारा, डेबिट कार्ड के द्वारा, राष्ट्रीयकृत बैंक के ड्राफ्ट के माध्यम से, जो कि सचिव NIOS नई दिल्ली या नोएडा के पक्ष में देय हो। भरे हुए आवेदन पत्र के साथ साथ डिमांड ड्राफ्ट और संलग्न किए जाने वाले दस्तावेज हैं जन्म रजिस्ट्रार के जिला कार्यालय से जारी जन्म प्रमाण पत्र की सत्यापित प्रति, जिसमें जन्म तिथि अंकित हो, पिछले विद्यालय से प्राप्त विद्यालय छोड़ने का प्रमाण पत्र जिसमें आवेदक की जन्म तिथि लिखी हो, प्रवेश फॉर्म का प्रिंट आउट NIOS के संबद्ध क्षेत्र केंद्रों पर 10 दिनों में पहुंच जाना चाहिए, अन्यथा उचित दस्तावेज ना लगे होने पर आवेदन फॉर्म रद्द किया जा सकता है। प्रवेश प्रक्रिया की पुष्टि होने के बाद शिक्षार्थियों को परिचय पत्र व अध्ययन सामग्री डाक द्वारा तुरंत पहुंचाई जाती है। ऑनलाइन प्रवेश एक बहुत ही सुगम और सुविधाजनक प्रवेश प्रणाली है। ऑनलाइन ऑन टाइम फॉर सेफ एंड सिक्योर एडमिशन।